welcome to Bite Size Med. This video is on the differences between the types of skeletal muscle fibers. Most textbooks will usually have tabular columns with all the differences listed out. If you're trying to figure that out, maybe I can help. Skeletal muscle fibers could be slow twitch or fast twitch fibers. The slow twitch fibers contract slowly and for longer durations with lesser force. The fast twitch fibers contract faster and for a shorter duration, but with more force. Let's go back a little to see how a skeletal muscle contracts. Skeletal muscles contract using contractile proteins, that's actin and myosin, which form filaments. The heads of the myosin molecules have ATPase activity. They hydrolyze adenosine triphosphate to adenosine diphosphate, and the energy is used to bend the myosin heads at the hinge region, dragging the actin filaments along with them inwards. This results in a muscle contraction. Now, this ATP hydrolysis, it could be fast or slow. That depends on myosin ATPase activity. So there are slow twitch skeletal muscle fibers, which have low myosin ATPase activity, and fast twitch fibers, which have a higher myosin ATPase activity. The slow twitch fibers are smaller, and the fast twitch fibers are larger. But where does this ATP come from? In the slow twitch fibers, which are also called the type 1 fibers, ATP comes from aerobic metabolism. That means it uses oxygen. This is by oxidative phosphorylation. These fibers are called the oxidative fibers. The fast twitch fibers that instead use anaerobic metabolism, that's ATP production without using oxygen, are the type 2B fibers. Yes, there's a type 2A as well, but we'll get to that in a bit. Type 2B fibers produce ATP from anaerobic glycolysis. Oxidative phosphorylation is more efficient, produces more ATP per cycle than anaerobic metabolism. So the slow fibers can work for longer without getting tired easily. They are resistant to fatigue. Anaerobic glycolysis produces lesser ATP per cycle. It's less efficient, so they are more easily fatigable. The type 2B fibers get energy from stored glycogen, so their glycogen content is higher. In between, we've got the type 2A fibers. These are the fast twitch fibers, but they use oxidative phosphorylation for ATP production, making them less fatigable than the type 2B fibers. But they can switch over to anaerobic glycolysis as well, so they do have a high glycogen content, while the type 1 fibers have lower glycogen. Obviously, the glycolytic capacity and the glycolytic enzymes will be the highest in the type 2B fibers and lowest in type 1, while they have a higher oxidative capacity and the oxidative enzymes are higher. It's something like two ends of a spectrum, with the type 2A fibers like intermediates in between. If we put the rate of force of contraction and the metabolism pathway together, the type 1 fibers are called the slow oxidative fibers. The type 2B fibers are the fast glycolytic fibers. And the type 2A are the fast oxidative, also called the fast oxidative glycolytic fibers. Oxidative phosphorylation needs mitochondria, making the slow oxidative fibers rich in mitochondria. The fast oxidative fibers have a lot of mitochondria as well. Where does the oxygen that they use come from? Red blood cells, which are in capillaries. That's why the slow fibers have a high capillary density. The fast oxidative fibers have a moderately high capillary density. Just like we have hemoglobin carrying oxygen in blood, muscles have myoglobin. It can bind to oxygen and store it for use. Slow fibers have a lot of myoglobin. The fast oxidative fibers do as well, just not as much. This myoglobin gives color to the muscle fibers, making the type 1 fibers red. And the type 2A fibers are red as well, just not as much, so we'll put down light red. But what about the type 2B fibers? Anaerobic metabolism. They don't need oxygen, so lesser mitochondria. They have a less dense capillary network, and they have less myoglobin, so instead of red, these are white fibers. It's not like different muscles in the body belong to each type, you know, that we can classify them under any one of the categories. But human muscles, they actually have a mix of the different types. So each muscle will have these three different fibers in different proportions. The function of the muscle would determine which type of fiber predominates. For example, the slow fibers would dominate in postural muscles. They have to contract for longer, using lesser force, and are resistant to fatigue. Like in marathon running. While muscles that are used for sprinting would have to contract for a shorter duration with more force and can fatigue easier. So they would have more of those fast glycolytic fibers. So every muscle has a different proportion of the type 1, type 2A, and type 2B fibers. That's the slow oxidative fibers, the fast oxidative glycolytic fibers, and the fast glycolytic fibers. And those are some of the differences between the skeletal muscle types. I'm sure there are more, but I hope this video was helpful. If it was, you can give it a like and subscribe to my channel. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.